Welcome to another Geekin video. Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button below and clicking the bell icon to be notified whenever we publish a new video. GMOs and hormonal balance in women. Genetically modified foods, or GMOs, have really been scrutinized lately. We all know why they exist. Corporations are looking to make a better product that they can make cheaper than the competition. They take their crops into their little labs and genetically engineer them to withstand many of the common crop problems today or other reasons. The problem is, these foods aren't natural, and recent studies show that whatever scientists are doing behind the scenes are affecting our bodies. One such way directly involves women and their hormones. Most common genetically modified foods. 1. Corn. Almost 85% of corn grown in the US is genetically modified. 2. Soy. Soy is the most heavily modified food in the United States, modified to have higher levels of oleic acid, an omega-9 fatty acid that may lower bad cholesterol, and is naturally found in olive oil. 3. Alfalfa. Alfalfa that is genetically engineered is made so to resist the herbicide Roundup. 4. Canola. About 90% canola crops in the United States are genetically modified. 5. Sugar. 50% of all U.S. sugar production is made up of genetically modified sugar beets and 95% of the sugar beet market. 6. Cows. In America, cows are fed RBGH, recombinant bovine growth hormone, to increase their production of milk. This practice is banned in the European Union, Australia, New Zealand, Japan and Canada, New Zealand and Australia. GMO labeling. GMO labeling is not required in the United States or Canada, though severe restrictions and bans exist in many other countries. In 2018, GMO foods was labeled by Whole Foods Markets, as it does in their Britain locations, as they are required to do by the European Union. Studies are scary. As if women didn't have enough problems dealing with the effects of their hormones spiraling out of control, a few studies have shown that genetically modified foods are causing estrogen levels to heighten to dangerous levels in women. One such study was done on rats eating corn that was genetically modified to withstand Roundup and then sprayed with Roundup as an herbicide. There were two groups of rats, one ate non-GMO corn and then given low doses of Roundup, and another group that was fed GMO corn and then given low doses of Roundup. The second group of rats grew huge mammary tumors and died 5 times sooner than the first group. Studies suggested that the tumors grew due to the disrupted hormones. Another study done in Brazil showed that genetically modified soy was causing an onslaught of problems to the reproductive system of rats. Women start their menstrual cycle naturally at a certain age. Rats, on the other hand, need to have male rats around them to get their bodies to react and begin to ovulate. In this study, there were no male rats in sight, yet the female rats that were fed genetically modified soy had blossomed into womanhood on their own. A closer look at these rats' uterus showed the lining had thickened and the glands were dilated. What does this prove? The genetically modified soy was affecting the ovaries of these rats, without a doubt. Another study done in Canada tested the blood of 30 pregnant women and their fetus, and 30 non-pregnant women who have had contact with GMO and herbicide-treated foods. Their blood contained those pesticides and the BT toxin in Monsanto's foods. Monsanto is the leading company in using GMOs. These toxins were proved to have most dangerous to the fetus, but also adversely affects the women's reproductive system. We aren't rats. It's understandable that we can't have studies done on women and our reproductive system isn't the same as female rats, but these studies prove one thing: GMOs aren't stable foods. They cause a change in the animals that eat them. We aren't rats, but we are animals. If genetically modified foods do affect the reproductive system of women, the way it did of these poor rats, it can cause a number of problems. This hormonal change could lead to heavier than normal and much more painful menstrual periods and/or a problem called endometriosis, a painful and sad disease of women in which the menstrual cycle flows into the body instead of out of it. It could also cause infertility. In addition, it can cause significantly higher rates of miscarriage. Are you willing to take the risk? There is no real proof but great suspicion. Why take the risk and eat genetically modified foods when it isn't necessary? We can easily take extra precaution to eliminate or at least drastically cut down on the amount of these foods we eat. Check the codes on your produce. An 8-digit code starting with a 5 means it's genetically modified. The best way to make sure you don't eat GMOs is to eat organically and locally whenever possible. Find a local farmer that buys organic seeds and buy from them. Eat grass-fed beef, free-range chicken, and wild fish. Eat smart and your hormones will thank you for it. If you've liked the video, give it a thumb up, leave a comment, and share with your friends. We thank you so much for watching. For more nutrition, health, and beauty tips, please subscribe to our channel.